7. Welcome to DPSJ. Today is 17th April. I am going to teach you today phrases and clauses. All of you please sit with your textbook and open page number 10. In your textbook phrases and clauses, there is no exercise given. So I will be giving you one exercise and that you have to download from the description. Okay? So first I am going to explain you what is phrases and clauses. So see, look at your book everyone. Examine the group of words in a corner. It makes sense but not complete sense. So I am telling you a word that is in a corner. So what meaning you are getting? It is giving you some sense, that is something is there in a corner, but what is there we don't know. So it is giving you some sense but not complete sense. Such a group of words which makes sense but not complete sense is called a phrase. So now let us see here the definition of phrase. So what is the definition of the phrase given here? A phrase is a group of words that makes sense but not complete sense, since it does not have a subject and a verb. Okay, I think the definition is also given in your book at last. So please learn this definition. So what is the definition? In the phrase what we see, there is group of words but it makes some sense but it doesn't give you a complete sense. It does not have a subject and a verb. Okay, now see some of the example is given in your book. The sun rises in the east. In the east is a phrase. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. On a wall is a phrase. There came a giant to my door. To my door is a phrase. It was a sunset of great beauty. Of great beauty is a phrase. The tops of the mountains were covered with snow. Of the mountains is phrase. Show me how to do it. How to do it is a phrase. Example, examine the group of words in bold in the following sentence. Now see this two sentences given here. He has a chain of gold. He has a chain which is made of gold. Now we recognize the first group of words as phrase. In the first sentence it is given only of gold. Of gold is a phrase. But in the second sentence it is there. See, it contains a subject and a predicate. Subject is which, okay, and the predicate is made of gold. So, is made of gold. So, this is a predicate. So, what now we will see what is a clause. So, in a clause you will get one subject and you will also get one verb. A clause is a group of words with a subject and a verb. And is usually a part of a sentence. So in a clause what you will get? A subject you will get and also you will get a verb. And it is also a part of a sentence and it may or may not make complete sense. So that is why in the second sentence, he has a chain which is made of gold. Here you will see which is subject and is made of gold is predicate. So this part which is made of gold is actually a clause. Okay, and here also some examples are given in page number 11. In the following sentences, the group of words in the bolds are clauses. Some examples are given. People who pay their debts are trusted. Who pay their debts? This is clause. We cannot start while it is raining. While it is raining is a clause. I think that you have made a mistake. You have made a mistake is a clause. Is it clear? So all of you will learn this chapter, the phrase and the clause, the definitions and the examples, and you will solve the exercise. And for solving that exercise, you will please click on the link from the description and download the exercise. Okay, thank you.